Hello everybody, in this video we will be doing a quick edit that will be very high quality. So let's just take our clips in here, and this is my photo actually, so I'm just going to keep it on the side. So we have our timeline, we have our videos, and we're going to get into it. So our first thing is going to be a very simple color grade. So we'll want to just color grade everything. So just go to the video up here, boom, and just go to it and watch how to color grade and then come back. Okay guys, so now that we are back, I just want to take this clip that I did and I want to go to other clips, and then just press the little mouse wheel and keep on doing that and mainly get the same type of footage. Now this JPEG, just gonna tweak it a bit, so I think I'm gonna delete these two on the JPEG, make it a little bit better. Okay, so now we shall go back, and we have mainly nicely color graded, made to look for the old fashioned, you know, TV-ish style. I'll try it at least. And then now what we need to do is look for transitions maybe. So start by having it go like that. That's not a bad idea. And then we don't really need, because it doesn't really let us, so we don't really need a transition over there. Okay. So I think the rest we just want for transitions. If you want to put transitions, then voice would be great, whatever. So now I want to add some cool effects. Very quick, very simple effects. So I will do just that. So let's look for one of the clips that let's say has more slow feel to it. Here, let's look. Let's say just this picture, okay? So make it a bit longer, and to give it sort of that live, more of a live feel to this picture, I will actually use something that is called, let me just find it in here, camera shake. Great. So we will just drop it onto here. And now when we run our photo, we'll actually have something that looks like a video. Now, does it really look like a video? Not exactly. So I will just tweak it. So here's a great tool. Do some motion blur. Here, motion blur. It's a bit hard for him to work with it. And of course, not really, you know, the best, but that's okay. Now, another way to make this picture look more alive is to add to it some type of text. So, we will add to it a title, let's say something more like this here, and this is how it looks. So, that doesn't really look perfect, I would say. So, we're just not going to use that one. So, not really that one. Let's try this one. Let's see how it looks. Now, that's not the best, but I think that will do. Not really good. Well, actually, that looks really cool. Let's try it. So, we will obviously not. You'll see. Main text. Let's just put back in my day. And that's it, really. We'll just put it like that. Now we'll make it some type of nice red. Maybe here some gray. You know, to make it nice. And then the video, we're just gonna zoom it out a lot, so That means when you run it, it'll be much smaller. Now we want to position it. At least I want to position it today here and up there. Okay. So this is how we're going to be doing it. We can even play with that. And now, let's go. And it looks like it will be running good. Just because it doesn't run perfectly now doesn't mean that it won't run good in the finished product. So I think that sort of gives it more feel of, you know, realer. So now let's see our finished product. Okay, so now that it is just rendering, you know how to do it, you just put it in here, put it in, render, that's it. So we will be back in a second to see the finished product. Boom!
This feeling inside my bones, it goes electric wavy when I turn it on. Off from my city, off from my home, we're flying up no ceiling when we in our zone. I got that sunshine in my pocket, got that good soul in my feet, I feel that happy.